Marriage and Divorce in Edith Wharton's The Other Two, and A Journey, a presentation by Angelica Gomez. Edith Wharton, 1862 to 1937, was born into a tightly controlled society at a time when women were discouraged from achieving anything other than marriage.
Edith Jones lived in a private universe of language and stories. Her vivid imagination conjured up much more interesting worlds than the one that she actually lived in. By the time she was a teenager, Edith Jones' compulsive need to make up stories resulted in her first novel.
At the age of 14, finishing it at the age of 15, she wrote this 30,000-word novella. She kept it secret, a novella called Fast and Loose that was set in the present time of the 1870s. It was about failed marriages of daughters trying to marry into aristocracy, the unhappy marriages that then came about from all of that.
The book went unpublished, but Edith Jones had a growing awareness of herself as a writer.
Wharton's consciousness of herself as an author included writing devastating reviews of her own work.
These imaginary reviews captured her worst fears about what critics might say.
In short, it is false charity to reader and writer to mince matters. Every character is a failure, the plot a vacuum, the style a fiasco.
Thesis: The Other Two and A Journey by Edith Wharton reflect Wharton's views of marriage as a business in which men are the dealers of women and the belief that a man's status is directly reflected by his wife's appearance and decorum in addition to his material possessions. But men are not the only ones who benefit from the transaction of marriage. Edith Wharton examined the role and status of women, the implication of marriage as seen through the eyes of a woman, the relationship between mother and child, and the rapidly changing views about divorce and about liaisons outside of marriage. If any consistent pattern of conviction emerges from the stories, it is that each woman must decide for herself what is best in her own situation. This is true of two-time divorcee Alice Haskett Waythorn and The Other Two. The only way for a woman to climb the social ladder during this time was through marriage and divorce, and Alice takes full advantage of the divorce law to climb to the top of the social ladder. When seeking a mate, do you consider their financial standing, style of dress, car type, dates, gift-giving ability? Alice fools her current husband, Waythorn, into believing that her first marriage ended because she was brutalized by Mr. Haskett. She then divorces him and marries Gus Varick, a man of high society. As the story progresses, the reader begins to realize that Alice is not the sweet angel her husband, Mr. Waythorn, believes her to be. He describes her as easy as an old shoe, a shoe too many feet had worn. A Journey tells the story of a young woman on a train to New York with her ill husband. While she did once love him, she is unsympathetic to his illness and no longer wishes to remain with him.
Fault was hers. She was too impenetrably healthy to be touched by the irrelevancies of disease. Her self-reproachful tenderness was tinged with the sense of his irrationality, She had a vague feeling that there was a purpose in his helpless tyrannies. The suddenness of the change had found her so unprepared. A year ago, their pulses had beat to one robust measure. Both had the same prodigal confidence in an exhaustless future. Now their energies no longer kept step. Hers still bounded ahead of life, preempting unclaimed regions of hope and activity, while his lagged behind, vainly struggling to overtake her.
Due to his illness, the narrator no longer has use for her husband. He can no longer provide for her in the ways that he used to. More lavish life. The stakes in marriage were even higher for Alice's character because she has a daughter to support.
She take my money when I'm in need. Yes, yeah, she's a trifling friend indeed. Oh, she's a gold digger. Way over time that digs on me. She kill me, mommy.
Now, I ain't saying she a gold digger. But she ain't messing with no broke. Now, I ain't saying she a gold digger.
Wharton's characterization of the women in her short stories are often harsh and make them seem shallow and materialistic, when in reality, these were intelligent women who had to do what they had to do. Both characters do show that they are aware that what they're doing isn't necessarily right and would be deemed unacceptable by society. Mrs. Waythorn lies to Mr. Waythorn about the reasons for her divorces, and the unnamed narrator in a journey is hesitant about abandoning her sick husband. In conclusion, the female characters in Edith Wharton's The Other Two and A Journey illustrate how women were not content with the basic lives they were forced to live. Instead, they used marriage and divorce as a means of liberation. During my research, I found an artistic spread done by Vogue entitled The Custom of the Country. Vogue recreates Edith Wharton's artistic Acadia, which I would like to share with you all. Thanks for watching.